Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Priyanka Singh Rao, scientist from Dairy Chemistry Division of ICAR, National Dairy Research Institute. Today I am going to talk about bioactive proteins and peptides in food from the paper Advances in Food Science and Technology. Before going to bioactive proteins, see what is food protein. Food protein is a substance that gives nutritional support to the body. It mainly consists of essential nutrients such as carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins or minerals. Among all these nutrients, protein is one of the major nutrients of food and essentially required in the body. The basic unit of protein structure is amino acid, and these two amino acids are linked by peptide bond to form a polymer chain. Proteins, other than their basic nutrition, also possess very good functional properties like whipping ability, forming, texturization, gelation and emulsification. Beyond this conventional nutritional and functional aspects, protein and their degradation product, which are known as peptides, are also biologically active and they modulate one or more metabolic process which prevents in the promotion of better health. Milk and eggs are two major sources of bioactive proteins and peptides. Other than these, proteins and peptides from plant sources like soy, wheat, brown rice, peas and corn, oats, and from animal sources like fish and collagen, they all are also biologically active. So, food proteins, as we had seen, that have physiological significance beyond the pure nutritional significance that concerns available nitrogen for normal growth and maintenance. So, the overall objective of this module is to make you understand or familiar with biologically active food proteins and many physiological active peptides derived from the protease activity from various food protein sources. Source of bioactive proteins. On the basis of sources, bioactive proteins can be classified into two groups, animal sources and plant sources. Among animal sources, milk is the major important animal source of bioactive proteins, along with that followed by egg, fish, and collagen. In plant sources, soy, wheat, brown rice, peas and corn and oats are biologically active proteins. Now let's start with bioactive proteins from animal sources. Among these, milk proteins are most biologically active, then egg proteins. Fish and meat proteins also possess bioactivity. About bovine milk proteins. Bovine milk contains on an average 3.5% protein, of which 80% is casein and 20% is whey protein. Casein, also known as phosphoprotein, exists in micellar form, consisting of more than 1,000 submicelles. different caseins present in milk are alpha S1, alpha S2, beta and kappa casein. This is all about casein. Among whey proteins present in milk, major are alpha lactalbumin, beta lactoglobulin, while bovine serum albumin, immunoglobulins, lactoferrins, lactoperoxidase, proteus pepton, and many enzymes are minor whey proteins. The table here show different protein present in milk and their bioactivity. Different casein fractions, alpha S1, alpha S2, beta and kappa have iron carrier activity and also immunomodulatory and anti-cardiogenic activity. While in the whey protein category, beta lactoglobulin have vitamin carrier activity and also they are potent antioxidant and fatty acid binder. Alpha lactoalbumin have calcium carrier activity and also immunomodulatory and anti-cardiogenic activity. And the third major whey protein is immunoglobulins with specific immune protection activity through antibodies, and they are also complement system. Other than beta lactoglobulin, alpha lactalbumin and immunoglobulin, certain minor whey proteins are also present in milk with different bioactivities. Among this, glycomacropeptide has antimicrobial and antithrombic activity, and it also acts as prebiotic. Another is lactoferrin. It also has antimicrobial, antioxidative, anti-cardiogenic, anti-inflammatory and activity. It also helps in iron transport and cell growth regulation, and it is a major precursor for antimicrobial peptide and immunomodulatory peptide. Lactose peroxidase, it also has antimicrobial activity and it has synergistic effect with immunoglobulins, lactoferrin and lysozyme. Lysozyme also has antimicrobial activity and the same function as lactoperoxidase. It is synergistic with immunoglobulin, lactoferrin and lactoperoxidase. The remaining minor whey proteins are present in very low concentration. In this, like growth factors, has stimulation of cell growth and it also has intestinal cell protection and repair activity, and it also helps in the regulation of immune system. The next animal protein is egg protein. Egg proteins are nutritionally complete with a good balance of essential amino acids, which are needed for building and repairing the cells in muscles and other body tissues. Egg proteins are distributed in all parts of the egg, but most of them are present in the egg white and egg yolk, amounting to 50 and 40% respectively. The remaining amount of protein is present in the eggshell and eggshell membrane. In addition to excellent nutritional value, egg proteins have unique biological activity. Lysozyme is present in egg white, have antibacterial, antiviral, and immunomodulatory activity, while immunoglobulin present in the egg yolk works against dental plaque formation. Other than lysozyme, avidin, OA transferrin, and OA mucin, which is a glycoprotein present in egg white, have anti-cancer activity, antibacterial activity, and anti-hemagglutination activity respectively. In egg yolk, lipoprotein present have the activity and enhance the growth and immunoglobulin secretion of HB40C5 cells. Phosphovitin, as the name indicates, have metal chelation activity and also antioxidant activity. The last animal source is fish and meat proteins. Fish and meat proteins provide valuable source for many proteins for many population around the world. Certain meat proteins have important physiological activities. For example, collagen has a positive influence on the delivery and bioactivity of bone morphogenic protein 2 and ecoptic bone formation, enhancing bone healing. While fish collagen protein, when orally administered, can repair damaged cartilage and can have synergistic effects with N-acetylglucosamine. Now we have seen the bioactive proteins from the animal sources. The next class is plant sources. The plant sources of protein usually include cereals such as wheat, corn, rice, barley, and some pseudo cereals such as buckwheat and amaranth. Other plant sources are legumes such as soy, pea, and chickpea. Brassicaceae species like mustard, rapeseed. Among all these plant sources, soybean contains about 40% and it is the most studied source of bioactive proteins. Proteins from soybean, cotyledons, and wheat germ have lipase inhibitory activity, which helps in delayed assimilation of fat in the body. So, this results in lower postprandial triglyceride and low density lipoprotein level and a better high density lipoprotein to total cholesterol ratio. These changes may be associated with the improved insulin sensitivity and lower risk of atherosclerosis, obesity, and other symptoms of the metabolic syndrome. Soybean protein has cholesterol lowering effect, which can be correlated with the bile acid binding epacity of these proteins. The next class of bioactive proteins are proteins from plant sources. Plant sources of protein usually include cereals such as wheat, corn, rice, barley, rye, and certain pseudoplastic cereals such as buckwheat and amaranth. Other plant sources are legumes such as soy, pea, and chickpea, brassicaceae species, and other. Among plant sources, soybean contains about 40% protein and it is the most studied source of bioactive proteins. Proteins from soybean cotyledons and wheat germ have lipase inhibitory activity, which helps in delayed assimilation of fat in the body. This results in lower postprandial triglyceride and low density lipoprotein levels and a better high density lipoprotein level to low total cholesterol ratio. These changes may be associated with improved insulin sensitivity and lower risk of atherosclerosis, obesity, and other symptoms of the metabolic syndrome. Soybean proteins has cholesterol lowering effect, which can be correlated with the bile acid binding capacity of these proteins. Bioactive peptides. Biological active peptides or functional peptides are food-derived peptides that, in addition to their nutritional value, exert a physiological effect in the body. They usually contain 3 to 20 amino acid residues per molecule. For example, caseinomorphopeptides, antioxidative peptides, but there is one exception, CMP, caseinomacropeptide, which contains 64 amino acid residue. Bioactive peptides may be absorbed through the intestine, where they subsequently enter the circulatory system intact to exert various physiological effects, or they may be produced local effects in the digestive tracts. They are hydrophobic in nature, and certain bioactive peptides have multifunctional activities also. The short peptides with 2 to 4 amino acid residues are stable against gastric condition and serum peptidases. Some peptides bind to specific epithelial receptor inside the intestinal lumen and induce physiological reaction. These peptides are inactive within the sequence of the parent protein molecule and can be liberated by different means like gastrointestinal digestion of protein like milk protein and also by the fermentation of protein source by proteolytic starter culture, and it can also be liberated by the hydrolysis of the protein through proteolytic enzymes. The first food-derived bioactive peptide was identified in 1950 when Melander, a scientist, reported that casein phosphorylated peptides enhanced vitamin D-independent bone calcification interacting in infants. Food-derived bioactive peptides have been shown to display a wide range of physiological functions. It is a diagram of different physiological functions exerted by food-derived bioactive peptides: antioxidative, antihypertensive, antithrombotic, and hypocholesterolemic peptides work on cardiovascular system. Next is opioid peptides with agonist and antagonist activity, and they are effective on nervous system. Mineral binding and antimicrobial peptides mainly work on gastrointestinal system, while immuno and cytomodulatory peptides are effective on immune system. Among bioactive peptides, let's start with the antimicrobial peptides. Antimicrobial peptides are cytolytic peptides and act directly on the membrane of the target cell. The net positive charge of antimicrobial peptide causes their preferential binding to more than one negatively charged target on bacteria, which may account for the selectivity of antimicrobial peptides. Proteins from different origins have been used to identify antimicrobial peptides like eggs, spinach, and marine fish. But the most studied food antimicrobial peptides are derived from milk proteins. Antimicrobial peptides act against different gram-positive as well as gram-negative bacteria like E. coli, Helicobacter, Listeria, Salmonella, and Staphylococcus. Other than this, they also act on yeast and filamentous fungi. These are the antimicrobial peptides derived from food sources. The most well-studied antimicrobial peptide is the lactoferricin. It is a fragment of lactoferrin from amino acid sequence 17 to 41. The disruption of normal membrane permeability is at least partially responsible for the antimicrobial mechanism of lactoferricin. Additionally, a few antibacterial peptides have been identified from alpha-S1 casein, alpha-S2 casein. Caseinophosphopeptide released from kappa casein with 106 to 169 amino acid residue during cheese manufacturing also has antimicrobial activity. It binds enterotoxin, modulates the immune system response, inhibits bacterial and viral adhesion, and suppress gastric secretion and promotes bifidobacterial growth. Additionally, a few antibacterial peptides have been identified from other food sources like ovatransferrin is a 92 amino acid fraction obtained from egg white protein, while paltobagrin from yellow catfish also possesses antimicrobial activity. The next bioactive peptide is opioid peptides. Opioid peptides are defined as peptides like enkephalins that have both affinity for opiate receptor and opiate-like effect, which inhibited by naloxone. They are having pharmacological similarity. Opioid peptide exert their activity by binding to specific receptors of the target cell. Individual receptors are responsible for the specific physiological effects. For example, the mu receptor for emotional behavior and suppression of intestinal motility, while the sigma receptor for emotional behavior and the kappa receptor for sedation and food intake. They have receptor ligands with agonist and antagonist activity and are characterized by distinct N-terminal sequence and also called as atypical opiopeptides, different from that of the typical endogenous opioid peptides. The typical opioid peptides all originate from three precursor proteins, endorphins, enkephalin, and dynorphins. All these typical opioid peptides have the same N-terminal sequence, tyrosine, glycine, glycine, and phenylalanine. Here, the table shows the different opioid peptides derived from food proteins. Opioid activity containing peptides were first found in the late 1970s, which was bovine beta-casomorphin 7 from casein hydrolysate. Further, exorphin and casoxin from alpha-S1 and kappa-casein respectively also found with opioid-like activity. Whey protein like alpha-lactalbumin, beta-lactalbumin, and serum albumin also gives opioid peptides like alpha-lactorphin, beta-lactorphin, and serorphin respectively. Opioid peptides also get released from plant sources like gluten, spinach, and soybean, and they are named as exorphin A4, rubisocholine 5, and soya morphin 5 respectively. Next is ACE inhibitory activity of peptide. Before knowing the ACE inhibitory activity, we should learn about hypertension. Hypertension leads to the development of cardiovascular disease such as stroke and heart failure, and it can be treated by dietary approaches, lifestyle changes like reduction of overweight, cessation of smoking and physical activity, or it can be treated by clinical practice in which vasodilators, diuretics, calcium channel blockers and angiotensin II receptor blockers and ACE inhibitors are mainly used. In human peripheral blood, pressure is regulated by renin angiotensin system, of which angiotensin converting enzyme, which is also called as ACE, is important. The picture here shows that the angiotensin converting enzyme is the exopeptidase that hydrolyzes an inactive decapeptide angiotensin 1 to the potent vasoconstrictor angiotensin 2 and degrade bradykinin, a vasodilatory peptide. Here the table shows the ACE inhibitory activity of peptide derived from bovine milk. They are generally short chain and 2 to 10 amino acid peptides, often carrying polar amino acid residues like proline, first obtained from a range of milk protein such as alpha-S1, beta and kappa casein, the major casein proteins in the milk, and among whey protein class, beta-lactoglobulin, alpha-lactalbumin and serum albumin also get antihypertensive peptides on hydrolysis. Other than milk, there are certain other animal sources which also gives ACE inhibitory peptide like meat, fish, egg as listed in the table, chicken muscle, sardine, meat muscle protein, fish muscle protein and add proteins like OA albumin and OA transferrins have different ACE inhibitory peptide. Table here shows different peptide fractions obtained from plant source of protein. Soybean, pea and maize protein zein are the major sources of ACE inhibitory peptide, while ACE inhibitory peptides have also been generated from some pseudo proteins like buckwheat. Broccoli and garlic also generate bioactive peptide with ACE inhibitory activity. This was all about ACE inhibitory peptides. The next category is antioxidative peptides. Antioxidant nature of any food component is most widely studied property or bioactive activity. The importance of this oxidation in the body and foodstuffs has been widely recognized. Oxidative metabolism is essential for the survival of cells. A side effect of this dependence is the production of free radicals and other reactive oxygen species that causes oxidative changes. So, these antioxidants are molecules which are present at relatively low concentration and can be prevent formation of radicals, or they can scavenge radicals like hydrogen peroxides and other peroxides. They work by scavenging free radicals, chelation of metal ion, and also by aldehyde adduction. The beneficial effect of food-derived antioxidants in health promotion and disease prevention are being increasingly recognized. So, we can see the nature of antioxidant peptide. Now, the antioxidant peptides are usually composed of only 5 to 10 amino acid residue, and their antioxidant mechanism are dependent on this amino acid composition. The most reactive are either sulfur containing side chains with cysteine and methionine, or aromatic side chains of tryptophan, tyrosine, phenylalanine, from which hydrogen is easily extracted. Histidine's imidazole containing side chain is also oxidatively labile. After knowing about the antioxidant peptides, let's see the example of antioxidant peptides derived from different food proteins. Antioxidant activity of bioactive peptide can be attributed to their radical scavenging, inhibition of lipid peroxidation, and metal ion chelation properties of the peptides. Several peptides derived hydrolyzed food proteins such as casein whey protein, soybean, rice bran, quinoa seed proteins, buckwheat proteins, egg yolk proteins, porcine myofibrillar proteins, and aquatic byproduct proteins possess antioxidant activity. The next important peptides are mineral binding peptides. Milk casein stabilizes calcium and phosphate ions. Tryptic digestion of the casein proteins yield caseinophosphopeptide from the N-terminus polar region, which contain cluster of phosphorylated serial residues. These phosphoserial clusters have been hypothesized to be responsible for the interaction between the caseins and calcium phosphate that leads to the formation of casein micelles. Caseinophosphopeptides retain the ability of whole casein to stabilize calcium and phosphate ion through the formation of complexes, thus enhancing their general bioavailability. Caseinophosphopeptide derived from the tryptic hydrolysis of casein represent phosphoserial rich peptides with divalent metal sequestering activity and possible roles to enhance mineral bioavailability. 30% of the phosphorus containing milk are present as monosters of serine and occur mainly in clusters. Most casinophosphopeptide share a common feature is that they constituted by a sequence of 3 phosphoseryl residues followed by 2 glutamic acid residues. The calcium binding constant of casinophosphopeptide is reported to be within 10^2 to 10^3 per mole. Peptide fractions derived from alpha casein have greater binding capacity of calcium than the beta casein peptide fraction at a high total calcium concentration. At a low concentration, the binding patterns are similar. This is probably due in part to the reduced number of phosphoseryl residue in beta casein. In addition, peptides binding mineral have been found in whey protein is that from beta lactoglobulin and alpha lactoalbumin and also in lactoferrin. Since these proteins are not phosphorylated, the mineral seems to bind through other binding sites in their casings. Beta-lactoglobulin and alpha-lactalbumin peptides show a higher affinity for iron than native proteins. Due to the mineral binding property of casinophosphopeptides, it has an anti-cariogenic effect and is used to different toothpaste and chewing gum. It is also act as antioxidant due to its mineral binding property. Other than milk protein, a fish bone phosphopeptide containing 23.6% of phosphorus and molecular weight of 3.5 kilodalton have been also isolated from tuna fish. It could bind calcium without the formation of insoluble calcium phosphate. The next class of bioactive peptide is immunomodulatory peptide. They are also called as cytomodulatory peptides. Immunomodulation involves suppression or stimulation of human immune functions. Immunomodulatory food peptides act by enhancing the function of immune system, including regulation of cytokine expression, antibody production, and reactive oxygen species induced immune function. Moreover, immunomodulatory peptides might reduce allergenic reactions in atopic humans and enhance mucosal immunity in the gastrointestinal tract. Food-derived bioactive peptides modulate stability of different cell types. Some milk-derived peptides have been shown to trigger apoptosis, especially in malignant cells, where normal cells seem to be less susceptible. Together, these cytomodulatory and immunomodulatory peptides might contribute to a certain protective action of food-derived peptides in tumor development. Table here shows the immuno and cytomodulatory peptide fractions from milk proteins like alpha casein, beta casein and kappa casein and certain whey proteins like alpha lactalbumin, lactoferrin. Other than this, peptides from rice and wheat proteins albumin and gluten respectively show immunomodulatory activity. Till now we had seen different peptides with specific bioactivity. Peptides have discovered from some food proteins and have reported to possess more than one significant physiological relevant bioactive property, and they are called as multifunctional peptides. Table here show certain example of this multifunctional peptides such as lactoferricin. It has antimicrobial, antifungal, anti-tumor and antiviral property due to the tryptophan arginine rich proportion of the peptide, and then anti-inflammatory and immunomodulating property because of its positive charge region of the molecule. Another, a hexapeptide derived from alpha S1 casein by trypsin catalyzed digestion exhibited both as inhibitory as well as immunomodulatory activity, while a beta lactoglobulin derived peptide beta lactoferrin inhibited as activity and also possess opioid like activity. So coming to the conclusion, what we have learned under this module. First, different sources of bioactive proteins from food sources, and we had seen that the milk from animal source is the major bioactive protein. Other than milk, egg is the second major protein which have good biologically activity. The next, what we had seen, bioactive peptides. Bioactive peptides derived through enzymatic hydrolysis of food proteins have demonstrated potential for application as health promoting agents against numerous human health diseases, conditions including cardiovascular diseases, inflammation and cancer. So the feasibility of pharmacological application of these peptides depends on absorption and bioavailability in intact form in the target tissue, which in turn depends on structure of the peptides. Therefore, production as well as processing of these peptides based on the important structure function parameters can lead to the production of potent bioactive peptides. Thank you.